Hello and welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we configure the ASA firewall for site-to-site VPN through going through the internet up to the headquarters, so to the HQ Fortigate firewall. So now let's jump and connect to the ASDM. Let's see if the session has expired or not. No, we're actually in. So let's go to wizards and let's say VPN wizards. And let's select site-to-site VPN wizard. So this is the setup and it is between two devices through the internet. This is what we need. So use this wizard to set up new site-to-site VPN tunnel. A tunnel between two devices is called a site-to-site tunnel and is bidirectional. A site-to-site VPN tunnel protects data using the IPsec protocol. Actually, it's IPsec protocol suite. So anyway, let's go and say next. So peer device identification, what's the IP address of, in this case, of the HQ Fortigate firewall? So let's check the diagram. And it's 80, 80, 80, and 81. So let's configure this. So the IP address is 80.80.80.81. VPN access interface, so we are accessing, we are reaching this IP address through the outside interface. Let's just click next. Now, what is the local network? So again, traffic to protect or the proxy ACL, what Cisco calls it, or interesting traffic. So what's my private IP address, my local LAN, and what's the remote network? What's the remote private network that we are going to talk to or connect to? So local network, I'll just click here. Our local network is this, inside network, 192.168.3.0. And I'll now click on local network. So that I select this this object. This is what they're called, they're objects. And I'll click OK. Now for the remote network, we don't have one defined. We do not have it in the list, so we'll just create one. So click on Add and say Network Object. The name will be, let's say, HQ Fortigate Private LAN. This is not a host, but this is a network. So the IP address will be 192.168.1.0. And the net mask is 255.255.255.0. So NAT, we will not add any NAT. So we don't want this traffic to be NATed. And let's just say, okay. I will select it now and say remote network is this and click okay. Now we have to say next. Now in this fourth step, the security step, we can say that select simple configuration or customized configuration. Now here's the thing. In the simple configuration option says ASA uses the pre-shared key entered here to authenticate this device with the peer. So remember on the Fortigate, we have defined the pre-shared key as Fortinet. ASDM will select common IKE and ISACAM security parameters for that will allow tunnel establishment. So it means that it will select, it will have more than one available as security associations, as proposals, better said. And from that list, the ASDM will try to select one in order to match 100% what the Fortigate will present when trying to establish the tunnel. But we are network engineers, we are going to select customized configuration. Why is this? Because we want to be as exact as possible and select only what we need, not select everything that's available, right? So let's go for IKE version 1. This is what we have configured on the Fortinet firewall. And the authentication method, so we are not using any certificate. The authentication is a pre-shared key. And let's say now Fortinet. So again, let me just make sure I'm typing it correctly. Fortinet encryption algorithms. So you see here that there are a lot of IKE policies and IPsec proposals. So we want to make sure that we select only what we need. PFS, we have selected PFS and the group was 5. Let's get back to encryption algorithms and say manage. Okay. And from this list, we will delete everything. And only let the one we need, so DES and SHA with pre-shared key. So I'll delete this one. And RSA SIG means authentication through certificates. We don't need it, so we need only this. We set DES as the encryption, SHA as the algorithm. Diffie-Hellman group, this is not good. I'll just say edit. And the Diffie-Hellman should be 5. This is what we said. This is what we have configured. So again, we have seen a bunch of things here, a bunch of IKEV1 policies. We have configured only one, and this is what we need. So let's just verify again. SHA, Diffie-Hellman group 5, pre-shared keys, and 86,400 seconds. If we look on the HQ Fortigate Firewall. So again, for the VPN to establish, we have to match these parameters. So if we go now into the custom one and say edit, let's go and for the phase one, we have DES, SHA-1, group 5. Perfect. And we have 86,400. I can remember it correctly. Anyway, just check. Edit 86,400,000 seconds for the key lifetime. Now I'll say cancel and get back to ASDM. So now I'll say okay. And this is the IKE policy. So this is pre-shared, DES and SHA. IPsec proposal now. Let's say select. Again, we have a bunch of them here. I will just go and delete everything. Hopefully it's possible. Actually, no, we have to select here on the list and delete everything that we don't need. And I will just leave this one, which is DES and SHA, and delete everything else. So I will assign as an IPsec proposal this. For this is for phase 2, by the way. So DES and SHA, and click OK. Again, if we go back to the Fortigate Firewall for the second tunnel, going to the ASA and click edit. Phase 2 selectors, click edit, and then move to the advanced section. We need DES and SHA-1 with PFS and group 5. So going back to this one, PFS has been enabled with group 5, encryption algorithm, ESP, DES, SHA. So we are ready to say next. Now, the NAT exempt. So this step allows you to exempt the local network address from network translation. And I'll just enable this option. We don't want traffic going from our private LAN going to the private LAN on the HQ side to be translated. Otherwise, the traffic will not flow correctly. So exempt ASA site host network from address translation in this, with this configuration, with this private IP addressing, 192.168.3.1/24. So this is good, and click next. So this is an overview of the configuration. Peer IP, this is the VPN access. We're using IKE version 1 with pre-shared key. PFS is enabled with group 5. IKEV1 policy, pre-shared DES, SHA, IPsec proposal, ESP encapsulating security payload with DES and SHA. And regarding NAT, the protected traffic is not subject to network address translation, which is good. I will now say, say finish. And luckily I have this option enabled, and I will show you exactly in a moment where you can enable it as well. So we are running, we are configuring basically everything we need in this graphical user interface. But basically what's happening behind the scenes is that at the end, a configuration is generated like you see here, and these commands will be pushed to the ASA device so that it is configured like you have we have entered in the graphical user interface. But there is an option that you have to check so that you can see the commands before they are pushed to the device. Anyway, now I will say send. And the configuration has been sent to the device. So here in file, let me just check. So tools, and let's see where it is. So file, no, view, tools, I think it's here. So tools, preferences, and here it is. So preview commands before sending them to the device. And I have enabled this option, and it's a good practice so that you also get a good understanding of what's happening there and what commands are really delivered to your device. Anyway, this has been the configuration to the ASA. Nothing more to be done now. Let's just meet in the next lecture where we do some testing and verification and any troubleshooting if needed. So thanks a lot and see you in the next section.